What's the best prenatal nutrition? Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode.
So, Kate Miller says, I'm planning on getting pregnant in the next 1.5 years. What length of time preconception should I take a prenatal, seeking health without iron? Should I start now and alternate months with a normal multivitamin? What kinds of nutritional status tests should I get preconception as someone who doesn't have anything obviously wrong going on? I would, number one, look, I think a thing that would be worth doing would be, number one, as soon as you know you're going to plan on getting pregnant in a year and a half, institute the prenatal conception. And the reason is we haven't really studied, like, what's the difference between doing it 3 months before versus 6 months before versus 12 months before. And so I don't see any harm for implementing the prenatal protocol a year and a half ahead of time. But as you know, many people get accidentally pregnant. And so you may be planning on a year and a half from now, but you might accidentally get pregnant 6 months from now. So if you are already in the mode of thinking about preparing, then I think it's time to just start preparing. Now, I think one thing that would be worth doing would be do a dietary analysis of your usual diet or the diet that you expect to be eating during the time leading up to the pregnancy, and do like a chronometer micronutrient analysis on at least a few different representative days, and either ignore their targets or alter their targets to be pregnancy targets. And I would recommend going through the Vitamins and Minerals 101 course into the How Much Do We Need section and see where I made notes about pregnancy targets. In general, I've accepted the RDA for pregnancy targets, but there are a couple cases where I've suggested a different target for pregnancy. So you might want to cross-reference the RDAs with what I put in the Vitamins and Minerals 101 course. I personally would recommend using my target because that's why I put it there. But see how your diet matches up. And I would look at your iron status too. I would look at your ferritin and your transferrin saturation or iron saturation, because I'm not sure why you're using the vitamin with no iron. But you definitely don't want to be anywhere near iron deficiency when you get pregnant, because that could compromise the long term being iron deficient during pregnancy and lactation. Feeding a diet an iron deficient diet could have very lasting consequences on cognitive skills and mental performance and IQ for the child. And so I think taking the preconception, the prenatal without iron is fine if your iron status is fine. But I think that you want to know that your iron status is fine if that's your approach, because the need for iron goes up a lot in pregnancy. What other kinds of nutritional status testing? I think across the board, it would be best to know that you're in good nutritional status. But the things that sort of stick out to me are you don't want to be vitamin A deficient or vitamin A toxic. So if you're right in the middle of the range, that would be the best thing. you really don't want to be deficient in anything. But some of the things that stick out are obviously everyone knows about folic, iron we just talked through. Choline is really important, but there's not really a good nutritional status test for choline. Biotin is very important. One third of mothers spontaneously become biotin deficient from pregnancy. And so I think that you want to be at least getting the RDA for biotin. Best test of biotin status is beta-hydroxyisovaleric acid, which is found on a Genova ion panel, which is kind of pricey, but is the best. I don't consider it a complete nutritional status testing panel, but it's the one large panel that has the most markers I would look for. And so, yeah, I think all the nutrients are important, but I would single out those as being the most important to look at. Okay, Kate, I hope I answered your question.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ MasterPass, a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. As a bonus, you also get to participate in monthly private Zoom Q&As with me. You can join the MasterPass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled out as Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for a 10% lifetime discount. For the remainder of 2020, I will be working full-time on finishing my Vitamins and Minerals 101 book while reserving a portion of my time for consulting clients. You can pre-order my book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. I will try to respond to comments here when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.